Yes, guys, just like last year, I signed up for the Indoor Clay Court Championship New Year's Day, trying to ring in 2023 in fine fashion. Salenko Tour by Diamond Rough string of choice inside of my trusted Dunlop CX200s. Made the lonely drive up to Culpeper, Virginia, reminiscing about last year's fiasco and how I capitulated at the hand of an 11-year-old. Upper right-hand corner right now to relive that trauma. Well, the tennis gods have a sense of humor, dealing me the same exact card back-to-back years. A middle schooler awaits, taking time away from his science fair project to challenge the California Condor on court for a right to make it to the semifinals. Will I lose once more to someone young enough who still believes in Santa, or will I finally fulfill my destiny and crush the middle school resistance?
So yes, guys, what a day for indoor clay. Oh, babies, locking horns with this middle schooler, and that is not a misnomer. Look at him, the physicality, or lack thereof on him. Severely underdeveloped, but he's 12 years old, so can't hold that against him. But to his credit, look at that, formidable strokes. Even though he's an outright child, doing battle with a grown 28-year-old male. And during warm-ups, I could just tell this is gonna go either way. Hitting me with the delectable dropper there. Very nice deuce. I was up 40-15 in good position here in this opening service game, and next thing I know, you can tell, getting into some rallies here down the middle, a lot of neutral balls, a lot of high arching looping balls, and a slice to stay within it, but you could tell it's a little bit of a coin toss here, and I just knew during warm-up, as I was mentioning, that this was going to be a gritty battle, baby. But there we go, hitting with some angle and turning that deuce point into add in. And a deeper turn handled with that one-hand backhand. Good to see. And here we go again. More rallies. As I hang in there and do get over the line initially. And look at that. Woof. Pause the thought there. Take a moment to admire the serves on the kid. 12 years old and some decent pace and pop on the serve, and there he is, clipping the line and sending me a nasty ricochet almost into my face there. Definitely worth the replay. So would do his part to get the opening hold, and here we go, 1-1. And oh my goodness, let's watch that one again. That is a touch and a half, baby. Woo, fluffy, soft and supple. My goodness, that is sexy. Nice little backhand dropper there. Excellent hands. There he goes. Oh, salivating at the prospect of hitting the tweener, baby. And no, executed nicely, but to no avail as it goes wide in the doubles alley. But despite losing that tweener, I would go on again to get that hold. So here we are, still on serve, getting into the net nicely there, tucking that volley away with some aplomb. It's 15-30. Could I make it a double break opportunity? Nope. That return is just far too shallow. He eats it for breakfast and executes the 1-2 punch. Well done. I tip my hat to the kid there. 30 all. And if you want to see how I fared last year in that vlog format, I know you know my fate, losing to the 11-year-old. But if you want to see that vlog format, upper right-hand corner right now. Goodness, tripping over the tongue. I think you'll enjoy it. My powers have doubled since I last arrived at this arena a year ago. Now I'm squaring off with a 12-year-old. I think you'll enjoy it as much as I just enjoyed that frozen rope, if you caught it, catching the line with the one-handed backhand. And how about that for a pickup? Woo, that is not easy, folks. Thoroughly enjoyed watching that one back right there. The one-handed half volley, digging it up off the baseline. Such good depth from him, but I handle it, and I turn the point around. I'm in, and yes, kiss of an angel, finishing it off and shaking the racket. Add out, though. In a bit of a precarious situation, facing a break point off the net court. But I retain the focus and the concentration, and he lets me off the hook. My goodness, how did I escape that point unscathed? Now it's add in, and I was hoping and praying that that would go long or wide, but I'm afraid, yep, sniping the line once more and drawing the applause from me. Add out, another break point. Can I come in clutch here? in this fifth game, the pressure was building, baby. It was building, and the thoughts were starting to circulate within my head. It was a bit of a whirlwind is the word I like to use. Oh, and it started spinning, and it was a vortex of thoughts and doubts there, double faulting, and just the body language says it all. Trying to retain control and focus, but it's oh so difficult, and the pressure is mounting at out in this 18-point service game, and it ends in brutal fashion, clipping the top of my frame and going awry as he gets the first break of the match. Curses, baby. So frustrating. And it's 40-15. He goes ahead and consolidates the break that he just earned to go up 4-2, as you'll see here shortly, despite me winning this point. And again, the problems would just persist. I felt like a kite in the middle of a hurricane, to reference the 007 movies. Just could not seem to stabilize my thoughts and performance. Look at that. Again, whirlwind of thoughts, emotions, frustrations. And in the midst of all of that chaos, I somehow strung together enough points, held together with duct tape, albeit, to get the hold and stay within touching distance. And how about that for a shot? If you caught that off the throat, shanking it. Somehow the tennis gods bless me. Here we go, 15 love, and scrambling like a man. He's making me dig deep for this point. Resetting with the lob, but I handle with the overhead, and I get in with the delicate touch once more. Oh, baby, exposing his speed there and winning a nice unorthodox point. Had a little bit of everything in it. And I'm in for 15-40 double break point, and I let him off the hook myself. Presented on a silver platter. What am I doing? Still break point, though. It's 30-40. Hitting down the middle. Trying to hit some high percentage shots, and I get a bad break there with a bad bounce. And it's just a dose of bad luck. 2 points later, though. At out still. Dumping into the net. And what was I saying earlier? The body language. The curses. Trying to stay focused, but it's oh so difficult, especially in the midst of a tournament here, especially when you're playing a child and it feels like you have everything to lose and not much at all to win, but cheaply giving me the break in the end. So the scoreboard leveled up late here, and ooh, the forehand hitting that over the shoulder may have been a little bit of a shankopotamus on that one, but I won't say anything. And ooh, the Chapeau special, the one-handed jumping backhand. Gotta love it. I'm in. And it's 15-30. And probably should have done a little bit more there to secure the point. And put it away nicely. Deuce here in this monumental ninth game, as we're both inching closer to that finish line here for the first set. I'm in. Way to approach, baby. And way to finish it. Nicely done, California Condor. And back to deuce here. Could not finish it off the first time. And shank a doodle do off the frame. And, oh, just don't even get me started. All these demons are flooding back into my head right now just watching this back. 4-5, double fault, no control. And speaking of no control, what is that? A 6'8" gargantuan storming onto the court. That's a hazard, to say the least. But stay tuned for that opponent you just saw. Hint, hint, nudge, nudge, wink, wink. We may or may not see him here in the near future. 5-4, middle schooler. Has it on his Yonex racket. Can he serve it out? Not if I have anything to say about it. He's getting into a little bit of a rally here. Hit to his forehand, and the error is drawn as that ball sails. And it's left 15, and something went off in my mind where I said, just screw it, man. I'm going to start smacking this thing silly. It's already a foregone conclusion. I know that the battle is all but lost, so I got nothing to lose here. Just start hitting it, baby. I don't care. And with a little bit of more of this reckless approach, it was actually more of an aggressive approach. And aggression can sometimes yield good results here. And next thing I know, it's left 30. And the break to level this thing at 5 is now just about a reality there. Triple break point would capitalize, and we send this thing into a tie break to fast forward. 6-all, 1-love him. Whoa, baby. Digging deep on that forehand. Hustling. and bustling. But he takes that point 4-1. I'm in a pickle, baby. And I don't know how. I just got a racket on that one and hope for the best. And this turned into that, baby! A little Gael Monfils elevation sensation. Orgasmic tennis, baby. Euphoric. And look at that, the scoreboard as I fast forward here. 7-6, 6-love. I steal the set like the Grinch stole Christmas. Crushed his spirits in doing so. And go on to bagel him. All credit to the kid, though, for giving me the scare. Thanks for tuning in. Be sure to subscribe. And remember that Trashman Tennis is all about the tennis trash. We've been. I will see you in the semis.